Today, we are going to discuss the current affairs of 14th April. Let's start. Who has been appointed as the new Executive Director of Union Bank of India? And it is Mr. Birupaksha Misra. Remember that Andhra Bank and Corporation Bank has been merged with the Union Bank of India. Moving on to the next point, which institute has developed the first remote health monitoring system in India? And it is the All India Institute of Medical Science, Rishikesh, along with Bharat Electronics Limited. And this system is to be started in the state of Uttarakhand. This allows doctors to monitor the body temperature of patients remotely and can provide monitoring kits. Remember, the Chief Minister of Uttarakhand is Mr. Trivendra Singh Rawat, and the Governor of Uttarakhand is Madam Baby Rani Maurya. Next, father of modern Iraqi architecture, Rifat Chatterjee, passed away. He has designed the Iraq's most valuable structures and the iconic Freedom Monument. Next, which state has become the first state of India to start clinical trial plasma therapy for COVID-19 treatment? And it is the state of Kerala. Indian Council of Medical Science has given approval to Sri Chithirathirunal Institute for Medical Science and Technology, Trivandrum, to start this treatment. It's a technique to take the plasma of patients who have completely recovered from coronavirus, and this plasma is rich in antibodies. This is infused into the COVID-19 patients who are critically ill and whose system cannot fight the virus. Next, a digital stethoscope has been developed by IIT Bombay to check patients who are infected with COVID-19. And the name of this digital stethoscope is AyuSync. This can listen and record heartbeats from a distance. This helps the doctors and medical professionals to practice social distancing with ease. Next, recently M.V. Rajasekharan passed away. He is associated with politics. He had served as the Union Minister of State for Planning in the Manmohan Singh Ministry. He represented the Kanakapura Lok Sabha constituency in Karnataka. Next, former Attorney General and Senior Advocate Ashok Desai passed away. Next, April 14th is observed as World Chagos Day. This is for the first time we are observing April 14th as the World Chagas Disease Day. This disease is caused by a parasite called Trypanosoma cruzi, and it's a protozoan. Remember, the headquarters of World Health Organization is Geneva in Switzerland. Next, Atal Innovation Mission, Niti Aayog and National Informatics Center have jointly launched a software called CollabCAD. This software is used for 3D product design. Remember, Niti Aayog is the replacement for Planning Commission, and It came into existence on 1st January 2015 and it stands for National Institution for Transforming India. Prime Minister is the chairperson of Niti Aayog. Now, the chairperson is Narendra Modi and vice chairperson is Rajiv Kumar. CEO of Niti Aayog is Amitabh Kant and it is headquartered in Delhi. Next, this is a science-based website launched by the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research, Indian Institute of Science and Tata Memorial Center. The name of this website is COVID Gyan. The aim of this is to create awareness in public about COVID-19 disease and potential measures to mitigate it. Moving on to the next point. Peter Bonatti passed away. He was the former Chelsea and England goalkeeper. Next, Prasar Bharati launched DD Retro. Public service broadcaster Prasar Bharati has launched a new channel specially dedicated to old classics like Ramayana, Chanakya, Shaktiman, etc. And the name of this channel is DD Retro. And with this, today's current affairs ends. Hope you all like